Welcome back, dear students. Now we are in the fourth chapter, transpiration. In the previous lecture we studied the definition of transpiration. Transpiration is a vital phenomenon where a loss of water in the form of vapors takes place from the aerial part of the plant. So transpiration we can define as loss of water in the form of vapors from the aerial parts of the plant is called as transpiration. There are three types of transpiration: cuticular transpiration, lenticular and stomatal transpiration. So when the transpiration takes place through the cuticle, that type is cuticular transpiration. When transpiration occurs through the lenticels, it is called as lenticular transpiration. When the transpiration occurs through the stomata, it is called as stomatal transpiration. So of these three types of transpiration, 80% to 90% of the water loss in the form of vapors has been takes place through the stomata, or one can say that through the stomatal transpiration. So in the further syllabus we are going to start, this is the only type, stomatal transpiration. In cuticular and denticular transpiration, the water loss was found to be the negligible. In case of cuticular transpiration, about 5% of the water loss takes place through the cuticle, and when the cuticle is thin, in such cases only the water loss has been takes place through the cuticle, or when there are some cracks in the cuticle. In case of lenticular transpiration, the only 0.1% of the water loss has been takes place through the lenticels. So these two types of transpiration are found to be not so important with respect to the water loss. In case of stomatal transpiration, 80% to 90% of the water loss has been takes place. So for that we are going to study our third point, structure of stomata. So as you know that the stomata are the minute pores or openings which are present in the epidermis of the leaves. So the stomata are present on the leaf surface, and as you know that the leaf has the outermost layer, we called it as the epidermis. So the stomata are present on the epidermis of the leaf. In some plant they are present on the both surface. For example, in case of monocot, in grasses the stomata are equal number on upper and lower surface, while in case of dicots they are present on only the lower surface, while in case of aquatic plants like Pistia and Eucornea, they are present only on the upper surface. So the stomata are the minute pores or openings which are present in the epidermis of the leaf. Each stoma, singular stoma, plural stomata, each stoma consists of an elliptical or crescent shaped pore surrounded by two specialized cells called as guard cells. So in the figure 5, if you see the structure of the stomata, in the middle of the stoma there is a pore or a opening having a shape of elliptical or crescent. That opening is called as stomatal pore or stomatal aperture. So this stomatal pore and aperture has been surrounded by two specialized cells called as the guard cells. So in the figure we see that the guard cell is kidney shape which surrounds the stomatal pore or stomatal aperture. Each guard cell is kidney shape as in dicot. So this stomata is the dicot stomata, or dumbbell shape as in monocot. So there are two shapes found in the guard cell. Some guard cells are kidney shape in case of dicots, while in case of monocot the guard cell is dumbbell shape. Each guard cell contains a nucleus, starch containing chloroplast and inner layer of cytoplasm, and a central vacuole filled with cell sap. If you see the structure of the each guard cell having a large prominent nucleus, it having a chloroplast. The chloroplast possesses starch, a lining layer of the cytoplasm, and a central vacuole which is filled with a cell sap. So as we seen the cell sap, it is the solution containing organic and inorganic substances dissolved in the water, that we call it as a cell sap. So it is a solution. They contain a large amount of protoplasm than their neighboring epidermal cell. So this is about the guard cell. So guard cell surrounds the elliptical or a crescent shape stomatal pore or stomatal aperture. Each guard cell is kidney shape in dicots and dumbbell shape in monocot. Each guard cell contain a nucleus, one more important, starch containing chloroplast, and lining layer of cytoplasm and a central vacuole filled with a cell sap. So these two points are important. Starch containing chloroplast has been present in the guard cell. Further, a central vacuole filled with a cell sap. They contain the large amount of protoplasm than their neighboring epidermal cell. So the guard cells are further surrounded by the epidermal cells. These are also called as the subsidiary cell. So each guard cell have two wall, inner wall and outer wall. So the wall that has been present towards inner side, towards the stomatal pore, the wall is called as inner wall, and the wall which is present opposite to this, it is the outer wall. So the inner wall of the guard cell is thicker and non-elastic, while the outer wall is thin and elastic, so it can be stretched. So the guard cell have two walls, inner wall and outer wall. The inner wall is thicker and non-elastic, so it cannot be stretched, while the outer wall is thin and elastic, so because of which it get stretched. So this is about the structure of the stomata. So this structure of the stomata favors the large amount of water loss through the stomatal pore or the stomatal aperture when the stomata is open during daytime. So the osmotic pressure of the guard cell plays an important role during the opening and the closing of the stomata. So now we are going to start the mechanism of opening and closing of stomata. Previously I was told that when the stomata are open, the water in the form of vapors has been lost to the outer atmosphere. So this phenomenon is called as the stomatal transpiration. So how the stomata get open and close, that I am going to explain with the help of a mechanism. So this is our fourth point, mechanism of opening and closing of stomata. During the study of structure of stomata, we seen that the inner wall of each guard cell is thick and non-elastic, while the outer wall is thin and elastic, so it can be stretched. Guard cells always have starch containing chloroplast, but the surrounding epidermal cells do not contain starch containing chloroplast. So this is the basic arrangement that has been present in the guard cell. It having starch containing chloroplast and its epidermal, surrounding epidermal cells do not contain starch containing chloroplast. Furthermore, guard cell having a large central vacuole filled with a cell sap. So these two conditions are favors the opening and the closing of the stomata. So the opening and the closing of the stomata has been based on the phenomenon of the osmosis. It depends on the osmotic pressure, turgor pressure. So how this work, I am going to explain it. As during the daytime, when there is a light, starch in the guard cell is converted into the sugar, for example glucose. As I was previously told that the guard cell containing chloroplast having starch, so it having starch containing chloroplast, and the neighboring epidermal cell do not contain starch containing chloroplast. So during the daytime, when there is a light, the starch in the guard cell is converted into the sugar, for example glucose. This conversion takes place in the presence of inorganic phosphate, and during this, an enzyme called phosphorylase act as a catalyst. So starch and inorganic phosphate, in the presence of an enzyme phosphorylase, has been converted into the glucose. So in short, we say that the starch is converted into the glucose in the presence of an enzyme phosphorylase during daytime when there is a light. So as the glucose has been formed during daytime by the conversion of starch into the glucose by the activity of phosphorylase enzyme, so glucose being soluble in water increases the osmotic pressure of the guard cell. As you know that the osmotic pressure depends on the concentration of the dissolved solutes. So when the glucose has been formed, it being soluble in water, it increases the osmotic pressure of the cell. Naturally, as a result of this, the guard cell draws or take up water from the neighboring mesophyll cells. So due to the increase in the osmotic pressure, the guard cell draws or take up water from the neighboring mesophyll cells. Due to diffusion of water into guard cell, the guard cells become turgid. So when the osmotic pressure of the guard cell has been increased, it draws water from the neighboring mesophyll cell. So due to the diffusion of water into the guard cell become turgid. The outer wall of the guard cell being thin and elastic, it get stretched. So due to the entry of water into the guard cell become turgid. It create a pressure called as the turgor pressure. So this pressure act on the wall of the guard cell. So as you know that the guard cell have inner wall and the outer wall. The inner wall is thick and non-elastic, while the outer wall is thin and elastic. So due to the entry of the water in the guard cell become turgid. So due to this, the outer wall of the guard cell, which is thin and elastic, get stretched or pull outward, while the inner wall of the guard cell, which is non-elastic, thick wall of the guard cell becomes concave. So as a result of this, the two guard cells move apart from each other and the stomata opens widely during the daytime. So due to the increase in the turgor pressure of the guard cell because of the entry of water from the neighboring mesophyll cell, the guard cell become turgid. The wall of the guard cell, the inner wall is thin and elastic, it get stretched, while the outer wall, which is outer wall of the guard cell, which is thin and elastic, get stretched, while the inner wall is thick and non-elastic. So the guard cell becomes concave. So as a result of this, two guard cells move apart from each other and the stoma opens widely during the daytime. When the stomata are open, water in the form of vapor from intercellular cells is lost to the outer atmosphere. So water in the form of vapors has been escaped through the intercellular spaces to the outer atmosphere when the stomata is, when the stomata are open. So in the figure 6, if you see that the guard cell having a sugar, for example glucose. So during daytime, what happen? The chloroplast containing starch, so the starch in the daytime has been converted into the sugar by the activity of enzyme phosphorylase. So the sugar form, for example glucose form, is being soluble in water. It increases the osmotic pressure of the guard cell. So due to which guard cell draws water, take up water from the neighboring subsidiary cells or the epidermal cell. So due to which the guard cell become turgid. So the outer wall of the guard cell is thin and elastic, it get stretched due to the turgidity, while the inner wall is thick and non-elastic, it becomes concave. So it pull apart or move apart the two guard cells and the stomata opens widely during the daytime. And when the stomata are open during the daytime, water in the form of vapors has been escaped out to the outer atmosphere. So this is the opening of the stomata. So the opening of the stomata takes place when the sugar is present in the guard cell. How the sugar is formed? So sugar has been formed from starch. Starch containing chloroplast has been present in the guard cell. So that starch, in the presence of inorganic phosphate, converts into the glucose being soluble in water. So when the glucose or a sugar present in the guard cell, the stomata are open. And under the condition of darkness, that is during night time, sugar of the guard cell is converted into the starch in the presence of the same enzyme phosphorylase. So during night time, when there is a darkness, sugar that has been formed during daytime in the guard cell is converted into the starch in the presence of enzyme phosphorylase. So in the reaction, the glucose has been converted into the starch by the activity of enzyme phosphorylase. So starch is insoluble and osmotically inactive substance, so due to which the osmotic pressure of the guard cell is decreased. Starch is insoluble because we know that the osmotic pressure depends on the concentration of the dissolved solute. Starch is insoluble, so it is osmotically inactive. It decreases the osmotic pressure of the guard cell. So as a result, water diffuses from the guard cells into the neighboring mesophyll cells or the subsidiary cells. Due to this, the turgor pressure of the guard cell decreases. So when the turgor pressure of the guard cell decreases, it loses its turgidity, means the guard cells become flaccid. Due to the loss of water from the guard cell into the neighboring, or due to the diffusion of water from guard cell into the neighboring mesophyll cells or subsidiary cells. So as a result, the guard cell become flaccid. Due to flaccidity of guard cell, stoma is partially or completely closed during night time. So in the figure 7, if you see that the guard cell having starch, the starch has been formed from the glucose. So initially during daytime, when the glucose is present, the stomata are open. But during night time, when there is a darkness, the glucose has been converted into the starch again in the presence of an enzyme phosphorylase. So when starch is present in the guard cell, it become flaccid. How it become flaccid? The starch is osmotically inactive because it is insoluble in water. So it decreases the osmotic pressure of the guard cell. So due to the decrease of the osmotic pressure, the water diffuses into the neighboring or the surrounding epidermal cells or subsidiary cell, due to which the guard cell becomes flaccid. And due to flaccidity of the guard cell, stoma is partially or completely closed during night time. When stomata are closed, the water in the form of vapors from intercellular spaces is not lost through the stomata to the outer atmosphere. So this is the mechanism of opening and the closing of stomata. So the opening of the stomata has been depends on conversion of starch into the glucose, while the closing of stomata is depends on the conversion of glucose again into the starch. So the sugar to starch and starch to sugar conversion are dependent on pH and temperature of the guard cell. During daytime, the pH of the guard cells remains 7, that is neutral or alkaline. It favors the conversion of starch into sugar, for example glucose. So when sugar, that is glucose, is present in the guard cells, stomata are open. How the stomata get open? As you know that glucose being soluble in water, it increases the osmotic pressure of the guard cell, so due to which guard cell draws water from the surrounding epidermal cells or subsidiary cell, so it makes the guard cell turgid. The outer wall of the guard cell is thin and elastic, it get stretched, while the inner wall is thick and non-elastic, it becomes concave, so due to which the two guard cells move apart from each other and it opens the stomata. So the pH of the guard cell during daytime, it is 7 or alkaline. So this pH favors the conversion of starch into the sugar. So when sugar is present in the guard cell, the stomata are open. So in the side, we see that during daytime, when the pH is 7 or neutral, the starch and inorganic phosphate has been converted into the glucose. So this pH favors the conversion of starch into the sugar, for example glucose. So this has been done in the presence of enzyme phosphorylase. But at night, CO2 is released in the guard cells. During respiration, CO2 is not used for photosynthesis. So CO2 that has been released in the guard cell by the process of respiration is not utilized, because during night time there is no sunlight. So in the absence of light, plant cannot perform the process of photosynthesis. So CO2 is not used for the photosynthesis. So due to release of CO2 in the guard cells, the pH of the guard cell becomes 5. So during daytime, the pH of the guard cell is 7. But due to the release of CO2 in the guard cell during night time, the pH becomes 5, that is acidic. So the acidity of the guard cells favors the conversion of sugar into starch at night time. So when starch is present in the guard cell, the stomata are closed at night. As you know that the starch is insoluble in water, so it is osmotically inactive. It decreases the osmotic pressure of the guard cell, due to which water from guard cell diffuses into the surrounding epidermal cells or subsidiary cell. So as a result of this, the guard cell become flaccid and the stomata are closed at night. So one can say that when starch is present in the guard cell, the stomata are closed at night. So acidic pH favors the conversion of glucose into the starch in the presence of an enzyme phosphorylase. So under such condition, when starch is present in the guard cell, the stomata are closed at night. Thus, opening and closing mechanism of stomata depends upon the changes in the turgor pressure of the guard cell. When the turgor pressure of the guard cell increases, the stomata get open, and when the turgor pressure decreases, stomata get closed. If there is increase in the turgor pressure of the guard cells, stomata open, and if the turgor pressure decreases, stomata close down. It is also known as sugar starch hypothesis, explaining the opening and the closing of stomata. So for stomata to open, the starch has to be converted into the glucose, and for closing of stomata, again that glucose has been converted into the starch. Both the conversion, that is starch to glucose and glucose to starch, has been catalyzed by the enzyme phosphorylase. So during daytime, starch is converted into the glucose. Under such condition, stomata get open, and during night time, the glucose is again converted into the starch, so due to which stomata get closed. So this is the mechanism of opening and the closing of stomata. So during this lecture, we studied the structure of the stomata. The stomata possesses minute pore or opening. So it having crescent shape or elliptical pore, that is surrounded by two guard cells. So guard cells are kidney shape in dicot, dumbbell shape in monocot. Guard cell having starch containing chloroplast, a large prominent nucleus and lining layer of cytoplasm. It also possesses central vacuole filled with a cell sap. The outer wall of the guard cell is thin and elastic, so it gets stretched, while the inner wall is thick and non-elastic, so it cannot stretch. Next to this is the mechanism of opening and closing of stomata. So opening and the closing of stomata depends on starch to glucose and glucose to starch conversion that has been carried out by the enzyme phosphorylase. So for opening of the stomata, the starch has to be converted into the glucose during daytime. Glucose is osmotically active. It increases the osmotic pressure, due to which guard cell draws water from the surrounding epidermal cell. As a result of this, the guard cell becomes turgid, because its outer wall is thin and elastic. It gets stretched, while inner wall is thick and non-elastic, it becomes concave. So as a result of this, the guard cells moves apart from each other and it opens the stomata. Now for the closing of stomata during night time, the glucose again converts into the starch by the activity of the same phosphorylase enzyme. Starch is insoluble in water, hence it is osmotically inactive. It decreases the osmotic pressure of the guard cell, due to which the water diffuses into the neighboring subsidiary or epidermal cell. As a result of this, guard cell becomes flaccid and stomata get closed. So this is the mechanism of opening and closing of stomata. Thank you. Stay safe, stay home.